French fries, burgers, pizza, chicken, milkshakes, hot dogs, sandwiches, milkshakes, hot dogs, sandwiches.
Hey folks, Crazyclimber80 here, Coach Shiley over there, and over yonder is a place called Super Deluxe that we are parked right outside of. It is a, I believe, a Portland area franchise, and there's like three locations.
Yeah, right? I know that there's the one out there, Foster Powell, the real rat hole of Portland.
Yeah.
That used to be a Taco Time for fucking ever, and that place has been jam-packed busy since it opened, and I think they shut down for the COVID for a while, but it was always a line all the way out onto the fucking street, so I never once thought about going there. But while we were out here serving the people yesterday, we drove past this Super Deluxe. I was like, oh, goddamn, that's a fucking winner chicken dinner for tomorrow.
This one is in Sherwood, and it is just off of 12th and Sherwood Road or
whatever. Yeah, Twelton Sherwood and 99 is a block away. Right fucking here. Yeah, whatever. Right here. There's a bullshit McMinimins right next to us and all that kind of cool shit. Across the street from Les Schwab, for those keeping score.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, we got a couple super deluxe double burgers.
Yes, and a super spicy chicken sandwich. And
we got an orange cream
milkshake. It looks nice and thick.
Yeah, real thick. This is clearly not a soft serve based one. Their shakes look pretty cool, actually. The strawberry one, I'm not a big berry guy, but the strawberry one, it was like all swirly. It wasn't just pink Pepto-Bismol looking.
Yeah. And this one is one of the seasonal shakes.
No, this is a regular. They only do a seasonal, and right now it's peppermint mocha.
Oh, that's right. That's what it was.
He doesn't do coffee at all, so it's especially on the no-fly list for him. But we didn't opt to get fries since I picked up some Royal Crown for us ahead of time. But it's only $1 to add on a drink and fries.
They
have crinkle-cut fries that are super crispy, allegedly.
I said super crispy in the description.
But, I mean, that's a pretty good little buy to do the combo. That makes all the sense in the world for a fucking dollar. Very simple menu, though. It is just the couple of burgers, basically a single and a double burger is what it looks like. A spicy chicken sandwich. I didn't even see a regular chicken sandwich. And then a veggie burger.
I think they did have a regular chicken, and then they had some chicken nuggets.
A veggie burger and a vegan burger. Pip.
Nice.
But only fries as far as sides go.
Yeah.
And then drinks and shakes and some kind of weird fucking sparkly fucking fruit concoction shit.
That sounds up my alley. No thanks.
But anyway, let's fucking dig in, man. I'm hungry.
Yeah, we like the setup of this place. It's really nice.
Nice
we
have ambiance, a weird, if you will.
We have a weird light that just flashes on and off every few seconds.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. But the inside, it's bright. It's all white and
nice
then
and bright.
Very basic, some yellow colors and all that kind of shit.
The staff is friendly. Moving. They're friendly and they are moving.
Yeah, they're busting their ass. We didn't. This is what four o'clock, 4:30, some shit that they're doing this.
Yeah.
And it's starting to get fucking busy. Not super busy here yet, but we came in, placed our order, had our food in less than fucking 5 minutes.
Oh yeah.
And everything is being made fresh. They're actually working a fucking flat top.
They've got a wide open space that the kitchen, everything is wide open. You can see over the counter what they're doing, and they're not stalling. They're moving their butts. They're doing a great job.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Absolutely. And like I said, friendly too. They were doing an interview while we're sitting right there, right in the fucking right in the shit. But anyway, without further ado, let's fucking dig in, dude.
Here's our bag. Here's the logo, Super Deluxe.
Yeah. I like the simplicity to it. Now, hopefully, it's fucking good so that it's
us napkins, right?
Yeah, that's nice. Oh, and they do not put mustard on their burgers because they're not disgusting fucking trolls. Special sauce, Okay, so it looks like fucking In-N-Out Burger.
Very similar. Yeah, a little bit. There's the...
So you get a special sauce and ketchup.
Yes.
And then, you know, the typical lettuce, tomato, that onion, looks, pickle.
Is that grilled onions? No, that's...
No, just this right here.
Is it? Really? Yeah. Well, let's get them a good look. This is one of the doubles. And like I said, we got each of us a double, and then the spicy chicken will split. And you can see the tomato. Lettuce is you know,
shredded
little.
Lettuce, or is it leaf?
It's shredded, but it's a little.
Shredded. I prefer
shredded. Yeah, me too. It's maybe not as fresh looking as, what was it, Culber's? That was like a, you know, a fresh. A
brand new shit, yeah.
Yeah, but it's that's all right. It doesn't have to be super, super immaculate or super fresh.
Looks like a fucking burger,
looks,
right?
Looks good. Little bit of tomato right there. That's all right.
And
we got diced onions right there, and we got what looks like, what is that, Thousand Island?
Yeah. Regular special sauce.
Okay, and there's that, and then...
we'll just grab the chicken sandwich after. Might as well dig into these.
Go ahead and
first.
Start with the...
I'll take the already did that one.
All right, we'll go ahead and get started.
Yeah, it does look good. Smells good. Yeah, and it's a... their Thousand Island type sauce is more of a orange or reddish color than like McDonald's one is.
Uh-huh.
You know, it almost looks more like a fucking French dressing or
something. McDonald's normally just... Or are you talking about the Big Mac?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's special sauce, yeah. I was just thinking of, like, most of their other burgers just have ketchup and mustard. Yeah.
Yeah, it's good. This is good. It is a mustard-based fucking special sauce, but it's not overpowering. It's a good burger, man.
It is.
It is, listen, it's very much in the In-N-Out double-double model. Same fucking thing. But you don't have to drive and stand in line.
The pickles are, is it the pickles that's almost sweet?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I do believe that is the case. Sweet pickles instead of like a more hardcore dill.
Slightly.
Yeah.
Not enough to be off-putting.
No, that's not it. There's something else that's sweet. Because I just ate a pickle by itself.
Oh, then it is the sauce. It's hard to tell. They kind of blend together sometimes. Mm-hmm. Oops. A little bit of onion that filled.
Yeah, I like this.
Yeah.
It's a good little burger.
Not bad at all.
So they're a little on the pricey side, because they're not exactly massive burgers.
No.
But these were about 7.5.
Yeah, so 7.5 or 8 or somewhere around that neighborhood.
But again, if you do it with a combo, the value is all there.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you add fries and a drink for $1. If you're getting this as a meal for less than $10, yeah, you can't go wrong with that.
Nope.
And I'm not, like, unhappy price-wise. You know, it's not like, oh, my God, it's...
Because like you weren't paying for it, like, motherfucker.
Like your sure shot.
Not okay, sure. I don't know why you gave that extra emphasis, but whatever, dude.
Because you fucking pronounce it hockey skate UFC. I don't know. That was...
This guy's stand-up really needs work.
That was value-wise not there. I didn't think the burgers were bad, but they were expensive for what you get.
Yeah, well,
this is all there.
This definitely has better value. But I thought they were good, but yeah, that. And it's hard to judge value these days.
This is true.
Everything is just way overpriced right now.
It's fucking. $35 for me to drive out here and back from fucking home.
For one, yeah. Yeah, I like that.
Mm-hmm.
Normally, I like my burgers to have onion slices instead of diced, but this is all right.
I like that. You know what I think the sweetness is, dude? I think it's got relish in the fucking secret sauce.
Maybe. I couldn't really tell. Because
it's not the pickle that's sweet. It's not the tomato that's sweet. And it's just little bits here and there. So I bet you that's what it is. There's a little bit of sweet relish in the fucking mix there.
Could be.
Yeah, this, I'm happy with this, dude.
No, I like this.
Yeah, fuck yeah. All right, bust out that other one for the people. And I'll kill the rest of mine.
Oh, okay.
I'm a little excited about the little chicken sandwich.
Yeah. Super spicy. We'll see whether super really means anything. All right. Looks like it could be very decent. It opens up a little bit better.
It helps that they have a pretty simple menu. Because just like In-N-Out, you know, you do only a handful of things and you crank out volume and quality.
Yeah. This has the same kind of sauce to it.
I would get is the...
And it's a little bit of lettuce.
I wonder if it is the same sauce or if it's a spicy sauce.
It looks the same.
Yeah, who knows?
That'd be decent. Looks good.
And that almost looks like a... either hand breaded or whatever patty. It doesn't look like a McChicken, you know?
No, it does look like it's a... It looks like it's hand breaded. We'll see.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, not super spicy, but...
There's a little zip there?
A little tiny bit.
Like spicy McChicken level of spicy?
Yeah, probably about that, but...
Obviously, the quality is far better.
Yeah. Yeah. Decent, I think, though.
You don't sound overly excited about it, so obviously the burger is the class.
The burger is the best part. I mean, this isn't bad. It's not a strong kick by any means, but
which is good though, because you're not a big spicy guy anyway, so you don't want it to kick you in the face.
Well, I can take a kick in the face every once in a while, but
and not just from the dog.
Idiot. Well, you have it.
All right, hand me that so I don't spill the shit everywhere. Well, that was perfect. I mean, it just dropped. Okay, yeah, so. I just.
And yeah, as much as I think the burger is good, the thing
I think just, it's the sauce that it's a different sauce. So it's a spicy sauce.
But it's still got a little.
Well, there's a little
something. Sweetness.
But yeah,
still
yeah, yeah.
A little sweetness.
Hey, well, I think it's the same sauce.
But
just
it just add
sriracha or something to it. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. But yeah, it's not strong by any means. But not bad. Yeah, the burger is the best thing. But my favorite thing about the visit was just how well run the place looked.
Yeah, that's all that, dude.
Yeah. The next time, we'll definitely want to get a cheap. Fries and
yeah, for the buck, why wouldn't
drink,
you?
Yeah,
grab the little shaky poo while you're at it.
Okay, well, I was gonna wait until you were done with that because you were gonna have a sip of this too. But all right, well, I'll just get started. So this is the orange cream milkshake, and it the color looks a little lighter.
Yeah, very pale.
And less artificial orange than everybody else's. So we'll see how it goes. It's got the same creamsicle. It's less thick than it looks. Pretty good. Oh, you still got some left?
No.
Or you did?
It's garbage. Okay. I fucking mashed that bitch.
Not bad. Yeah. It does. It is a lot thinner than it seems.
Oh yeah, it sure. Maybe because it came to temp or something.
It sure melted a little bit
over there. Yeah, that's good. It's it tastes like it's got like orange juice.
Yeah, Well, they have fresh orange juice here too. So maybe that's what's going into that.
You have orange juice?
Yeah.
Really? How weird. Oh, yeah, here's your double burger and a fucking OJ.
To make sure you get nutrition.
Yeah, you can't be getting fucking scurvy.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like that. It's not super strong orange, but it's almost like a vanilla shake with a little orange to it.
Yeah.
But I like it. I'm a big fan of the Dreamsicle or Creamsicle, whatever the fuck you call them. Shakes to begin with.
I wouldn't mind trying the strawberry, the picture of the strawberry one looked really good.
And then there's
really
a
good cold
brew one, which is not up Goober's alley at all.
Sometimes coffee ice cream can be decent.
Yeah, yeah.
Coffee shakes.
But anyway, this is successful. It is actually better than I thought it was going to be.
Yeah, I was happy, and yeah, it was a complete 180 from Shake Shack.
And you cannot order ahead of time. Call in your, which, I mean, not a huge deal. We usually, for you, the people, we call our orders in ahead of time so we can just show up, grab the shit, and sit out front in the Jeep.
We did not have a wait at all. Uh-uh. We just went right in, placed our order, and sat there for like less than 5 minutes, and
boom,
was
done. And the shake was up pronto.
Mm-hmm. They got that right away. So yeah, we were quite happy. Quite happy the way the place was efficiently run.
Yeah, and I would guess that you could probably get the spicy sauce on the burger. I would be in on that. Cuz I'm sure it's just the same base sauce with something that makes it spicy. Mm-hmm. And they put like a double portion on the chicken sandwich versus mm-hmm. the sauce that was on the burger itself.
Yeah.
But yeah, fuck yeah.
Pretty happy.
Nice surprise. Happy with this.
So at least that's the experience that we got at the Sherwood location of Super Deluxe. I don't know about the other ones, but
you would assume it's got to be fairly similar. I mean,
you would hope.
I think it's just a local 3-restaurant group. And like I said, the one out there on Foster Powell is fucking slammed all the time.
Yeah,
so,
this one is super new, so
yeah,
their business isn't quite where they'd like it to be yet, but I would hope that people appreciate.
Oh, it's going to do well. It's going to do well, and it's in a neighborhood that's going to support it properly. You know, Sherwood. There's a lot of money out here.
Sherwood's ever expanding, right
and
now.
Not to mention like Bull Mountain area of Tigers just down the fucking road. Shoals here, Murray Shoals is just down the other way there off of Roy Rogers. So,
mm-hmm.
But anyway, again, this. Very successful and no mustard.
Yeah,
we're fucking knocking it out of the park.
Yeah, this was terrific. This was Super Deluxe, the Sherwood location just off of 12th and Sherwood Road. Very good. We highly recommend the double is the one that always seems to get the notice, and it was very good.
It was absolutely worthwhile.
Mm-hmm. So get that and the fries and the Coke with it for just a buck.
Yep.
So that's it for me. Crazyclimber80 here.
See you, folks.
Coach Shiley over there from Super Deluxe, and we'll catch you later with another review.
Bye-bye.
Peace out, folks. French fries.